friends, and today we are here to talk about Great Bangladesh Wall. Have you ever heard about Great Bangladesh Wall? I'm also a little bit confused because I never heard about anything like this, but what we see, it's also looks like the rest over the last of Great Bangladesh Wall, like Chinese Wall. Also huge construction. I never heard about it. I was not going to visit it. Look like a kind of gate. But somebody cut it. What I see here is a huge amount of bricks. I didn't know about it. I didn't plan to visit it. It was by occasion, you know. Accident, incident, whatever. Coincidence. Well, we see here a gate. It was a kind of entrance. I was surprised. We will go into another place called Mahavihara. I heard about it. I know what is it. I will make a video about it. It's gonna be one of the next videos. It's a huge raider, ancient raider. I will explain you why. But this is kind of waveguide for going to this antenna. Going to raider, to this pyramid.
It goes for miles.
We came to another place after about 10 kilometers and we saw this. And they say they claim the 500 something year from birth of Jesus, no, 6th century. It was kind of empire and they built something here. It's this official bullshit. I will try to put some links for it, but at least this kind of tourist attraction, yes, they tell about it. But what I saw before, it was the same wall but far away from this place, remote place, and it looks absolutely the same. I walked for maybe a couple of kilometers. I was tired, it was hot, but I wanted to find the end. I didn't find the end. Really? I planned to visit another place, so I could not afford myself to go any further. But what I see here is enough to understand what is it.
Вот что это такое может быть? What it possibly can be? No idea.
I cannot imagine it's something that people more than 1,000 years ago could build. It's amount of bricks, if it's 10 miles, about 6 meters height and 4 meters width, amount of bricks necessary to build it, it's more than country like France produced for a year, approximately. In 2001, for 2 years. Why France? Because it's a big country. Everybody knows. Why 2001? Because in 2001, France was producing some bricks. Now, France doesn't produce almost anything. Because of many reasons, I mean anything in construction materials. And now we're going to excavation, place of excavations. And I will show you very interesting proof of mud flood. We can see it here, but it's nothing important. We'll go further in a different place and we will see interesting. A lot of structures. Buried, destroyed, demolished by explosion. It's like cut it explosion was really close. And what we see here? They were digging for a couple of meters. And we see it's not a wall. We see a lot of bricks crashed.
Это не стена. Просто как обрезали ее. Вот стена.
And then covered by glue. Mixed with glue. So a lot of trash and bricks were lying around. And then some glue with rain, with ash coming from top. Filled all this space. And we can see it on huge distances, huge areas. The same situation. Look. It was kind of city. The same walls. This structure was for radiating something. I will explain you later. This is roof of something. Because it's all not flooded, about 3-6 meters of glue after atomic bombing was huge rains with ash, so everything was buried, covered by glue. This artificial glue. But we will talk about it later. Now, what is important? Amount of bricks. What amount of heat is needed to make so many bricks? They are very strong, very good quality. They are still in very good condition. They are very solid. I'm kind of a little bit shaken because I was jumping, sorry. But it's not important. What is important? Walls. Too many of them. In a huge area. It's a very small piece of area which, like this. And now we see the real picture, the real depths of this building. It's also kind of monolith. But we see on the left it was building, kind of construction. And on the right we can see black soil. It was original soil, but I'm not sure. We can go deeper differently. But look at what we did see, 3 meters. Covered by parts of bricks, smashed by explosion, and it was a mix of glue and bricks. And the same situation in huge areas. You can see some locals.
Бабуль.
Yeah, my driver is coming. It's another place, also on the way there. It looks like Greece temple, foundation of Greece temple, the same. We were a little bit lost, we asked where to go to the digging, and we were sent here. It's not what we were searching for, but it's another place. Nobody heard anything about it. It's on the Starford-shaped area. It was kind of also waveguide. But foundation, oh, like Greece temple, Roman style. And nobody gives a shit, what is it? Also, very solid, huge, megalithic structure, but made of bricks. And now, it's another place. The same wall. We get back. Some kind of structure was here. Also waveguide to the source of water. Because water is source of energy. There's a whole structure, this waveguide was feeded from the water, like an Egyptian pyramid.
It's like cut it.
And I went down and to look from down. And what I see here? This hole, like resonators, also interesting. I'll explain you what they are for. They are in all megaliths, the same, like in Camerton. The same holes. This is waveguide to transmit energy. From here to there. This is bridge, look like bridge everywhere. But it's not bridge. No river, no water yet. At least in 100 years. But it's not interesting. What is interesting in a future video, just take a look. The same structure, the same lines, the same waveguides, but they were going. I know what wall was leading to. Was leading to here, to send energy to this place. And you will see it in next video. What is this place? Mahavihara. So, thank you for your attention. See you later, guys. Bye-bye.